everybody, happy Valentine's Day. I wanted to wish you the best of love on this Valentine's Day. And Valentine's Day is the day to be loved. And it doesn't matter if you have somebody to be loved by, or it's just you who loves you. You still need to pamper yourself this day and show yourself some love. So I would suggest for the best Valentine's Day, you need to start with a great morning. You need to wake up, open up the curtains, let the sun in, enjoy the beginning of your day. Then you can kiss your loved ones, say how much you love them, and continue with your day. Or if you don't have a loved one, why not love yourself? Take a mirror and say, I love you so much. Happy Valentine's Day. And just enjoy yourself today. Or you could get yourself some flowers and enjoy them for the rest of the day. Or you can get yourself some flowers and chocolate ice cream and enjoy all that the whole day. No matter what you do, just try to feel loved, whether it's with your own help or with somebody else's help. I hope you enjoy this Valentine's Day, and here's a quick tip of how to do nice romantic breakfast for your loved one this day. Okay, so to start our recipe, we'll need some sausages, and in this case I have Russian sausages. It's actually a Russian brand, but you can see these are chicken wieners, so they just come with the cover. Then we'll need some eggs, either white or brown, doesn't really matter. We'll need one egg for one sausage. Then we have some tomatoes that I will put additionally to this dish, just to garnish it and make it look pretty and more cute for Valentine's Day. And of course we have some herbs to accent it all out. Okay, so once again I have sausages. That's a Russian brand, and they actually come in a non-soluble cover, so I have to cut it off and take it off the sausage, which I will do. And we start with the full sausage, and obviously you can use soy ones or chicken or beef, whichever ones you would like. Doesn't matter, it's really just for the look. Okay, so I'm going to metal like so. And this is basically what it looks like. It actually looks just like bologna that you will find in the store. So now we'll take pot with boiling water. I already have one boiling there, and I'll just boil it for about maybe 10 minutes or so on the medium set, and move it back. Alright, so now that our sausages are boiled, and the reason really for boiling it is that they become more bendable and it's easier for you to shape them into the heart. I know that it looks weird, but, you know, stay with me. So basically what we'll do, we'll need to cut half of them, like split them into half, but not all the way through. Okay. And being very careful, we shape our heart. Now, once it's cooked, you can easily remove the toothpick, and it's not gonna stain. Right now, we just put it in to keep the shape. Okay, so you see the heart is one. Be very careful. I would bring it together on the bottom. And I would pin it down. So we have our two little hearts. Let's put them on the frying pan. Okay, so you can hear it sizzling already, and it's actually pretty much done on one side, so I'll just flip it over this side. You can see one of the sides is nice and brown. see. So you can see how I put that, okay? Now, what we'll do right now is take them off that one well and try and spray it in the middle of the heart. Okay, now we'll take eggs. Each egg, one heart, and I'm going to break it, and I'm going to try to position the yolk itself in the very middle. I will try to do that. Don't worry if that happens, because once the egg is done, I'll just cut it off. No imperfection. Let's do the other one. Okay. I'm going to lower it to low. I'm going to put some salt into the bag. Okay. And we're going to cover it up and leave it alone for quite a few minutes. And we'll be back when it's done. Alright, so about 7 minutes later, we're basically all done. So I'm going to cut off those extra pieces that's sticking out. A little tricky. Okay, so that should be fine, and I'll take out the toothpicks once I have these on the plate and ready to go. Okay, so let's see the results. Now we're going to use some tomatoes for the garnish of our dish today. And I picked some of these cute little cherry sweet tomatoes. They're pretty nice. They're quite ripe, but not too much. You can see some green around the top here. And we're going to cut them up in just halves. We're basically going to surround our little hearts there with these tomatoes around them. I'll just take quite a few of them and cut them in halves. Okay. This will give us color to our dish and more freshness, because we're using very heavy ingredients such as eggs and sausages, and it's not very fruity. Doesn't have that much fresh vitamins that vegetables give you, so tomatoes is always the best way to go. Okay. So, plus they're cute and they're really tiny, so you can just pop one in your mouth and it's going to be bursting with flavor. And it's nice in the morning, and I really like the combination of tomatoes and eggs and sauce. So I think that should be fine, and let's garnish our dish. Okay, so now we're going to garnish it all, and I decided to serve it with some strawberries and whipped cream on the side, and some Earl Grey tea, slightly sweetened. I think it should be good. That's it, kisses. Now we're going to put lettuce. Around the plate in a cute little way, so it looks a little bit more festive. And again, with that extra pop of color, because as you know, food is not only the taste, it's the smell and the look of it. So it's sometimes all about presentation, so I'll do it like that. And I have my eggs already ready. Put them in place. Like this. like, it just picks out, you see, and it stays in place. And the other one. It's a little bit hot, but I need to fix it up. Maybe like this. Yes. Now I have my tomatoes, and I'm going to just circle the hearts with them. We're gonna go around them a little bit. I don't know how much we actually will do. Let me just move it around a little bit. I'm just improvising right now to tell you the truth. Obviously you can do it face up or face down with the tomatoes. Carefully just positioning them around all the hearts to impress on the tomatoes, or to get release the juice. We don't want that. Okay, so that looks good, I think. And I have some of my dill. And maybe some more on the bottoms here. Okay. And because the way we cooked these eggs is that they won't really cool down real quick because they're really hot inside. And obviously you can pepper it up. Do a little bit. Just a tiny bit. Alright. Okay. So, here's our breakfast for our loved one on a Valentine's Day. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was helpful for you. I hope you liked the whole composition and the idea for it. And happy Valentine's Day, you guys.